Norwegian shipbuilders have been busy designing and building emission-free ships. The emission-free ships have been placed on domestic routes, especially in the mountainous west coast, where ferries are an essential piece of the transport network. Aiding this shift is a government policy that puts its full weight behind innovation in the maritime sector, offering support to operators who opt for more expensive, clean energy ships, and gradually bringing in requirements for the sector to move away from burning fossil fuels altogether. That has positioned Norway as a leader in green shipping technology and has made it the most electrified shipping nation in the world. Most of the maritime vessels in the world that are fully or partly powered by batteries are in Norway. And the number of electric-powered car ferries is set to nearly double by the end of this year. Alongside these is a growing fleet of battery-powered sightseeing ferries cruising in the fjords. All of this is happening alongside a number of other shipping projects in Norway that could redefine what's possible in the industry, and at a quicker pace than previously thought. One electric ferry, dubbed Riga Electra, debuted last summer. It was dubbed the fastest and longest range electric ferry in the world. With batteries, it's a challenge to achieve both at the same time. As anyone with an electric car will know, going fast tends to dramatically reduce range. The Norwegian government has set out to cut emissions from domestic shipping and fisheries in half by 2030. That means there's significant domestic demand for emission-free ferries. For now, Norway's faster, long-distance ferries, the kind that traverse the sea at 30 knots plus between larger coastal cities, still run on diesel, because battery technology isn't yet capable of keeping up. Norway's oil and gas wealth is precisely what allows the country to fund an ambitious push away from fossil fuels. For the government, now is the time to plot out a post-oil future that allows Norway to maintain its current living standards using other revenue generators and transport methods. One significant recent move by the government was to impose a ban on diesel ships in all of its UNESCO-designated fjords starting in 2026. Some operators have already made the switch. Charging infrastructure and insufficient electrical grid capacity is emerging as a serious potential issue standing in the way of all electric transport well beyond shipping. Future world in which trucks, ferries, and other commercial operators run on electricity across the entire logistics chain, in other words, would put a great deal of added demand on the existing grid. That's especially true in the small and remote communities of Norway, but that fact has made charging an important area for innovation as well. The sector must aim for net zero emissions by 2050, and that will require significant increase in use of batteries, shore power, and hydrogen-based fuels such as ammonia. This is how we move. I'm Gabriel Lee. For more on the future of transportation, follow QuickTake and Bloomberg.